The wake of Jullebee Ranara began Sunday after an autopsy was conducted on the remains of the Filipino worker. Some government officials came to express their sympathies and offered assistance to the bereaved family. Our correspondent Stanley Gajete has the details.
On the first day of the wake, relatives and friends came to grieve with the family of Jullebee. But for now, the family appealed for privacy. The wake is heavily guarded, with police officers and staff from the Overseas Workers Welfare Administration and Department of Migrant Workers.
Gusto natin pagbigyan yung pamilya na sila muna yung makapagluksa. Kasi yung mga kamag-anak nila nagdatingan. Ayaw lang kasi nilang paulit-ulit na i-recall yung nangyari sa kanilang anak.
I think ang balak nila mga 2 weeks yung wake kasi may magmumula pa raw na probinsya na iniintay nila. And of course, yung sister na magbumula ng Kuala Lumpur, Malaysia.
The family also requested mourners who wish to bring flowers to pick red roses instead.
Ang paborito pala na bulaklak ni Jullebee ay pulang rosas. Kaya sa huling gabi, pupunuin namin ng pulang rosas yung gilid ng kabaong. Ngayon kasi all white eh. Pero ang request ng pamilya dahil yung pala yung paborito nung anak nila.
Jullebee's remains arrived in her home in Las Piñas early Sunday morning after undergoing a separate autopsy conducted by the National Bureau of Investigation. This was upon the request of the family despite the first autopsy by the Kuwaiti government. According to Migrant Workers Secretary Susan Ople, results of the autopsy will be released in the coming weeks and will be directly sent to Jullebee's family. She says the Philippine government is still weighing future labor measures and their possible impact if a total deployment ban pushes through.
Ina-assure lang namin ang lahat na hindi namin binabaliwala yung nangyari kay Jullebee at may mga pagbabago na mangyayari. Kasi ang mahalaga sa ngayon yung pursuit of justice. So, yung pagtutok sa kaso, yung deployment ban kasi, magiging basihan yan yung pag-uusap namin with my counterpart sa Kuwait, kung anong reaction, especially given yung nangyari.
There are about 270,000 Filipinos working in Kuwait and about 190,000 are domestic workers. The department will hold talks with different recruitment agencies processing work opportunities in Kuwait to assess if they are constantly monitoring the welfare of Filipino workers. Ople adds, Jullebee's recruitment agencies will be held accountable.
Definitely, meron. I think papatawag sila ngayon ng adjudication at licensing at recruitment violations. Kaya yung failure to monitor, isa yon. And kahit yung doon sa Kuwait na recruitment agency nila, pananagutin din natin.
The family is demanding for swift justice. They hope Jullebee's gruesome killing won't just be another statistic, a number added to the thousands of OFWs who suffered and met deaths in the Middle East. Stanley Gayete, CNN Philippines.